cancer, disease, illness. My family is going through a lot right now. I'm sure that you know someone or yourself are going through something like this right now. When we go through pain, we all have our coping mechanisms. And for me, I go right to what I do still every day, and that's study health. I figured I was past the point of diet until someone led me to a new doctor. I'll get to that in a minute. But I've been studying this for a fair amount of time now, and my clients come to me, ask me for diet advice. I always recommend you're better off to eat more plants than not, right? You're better off to eat more nuts, more seeds, more salads, more fruits than to eat more pastas and more pizzas. So I recommend the alkaline diet. I recommend eating mostly plants. If you're going to eat meats, make them white. Make red meat very sparingly if you're going that way, like once a month sparingly. We already know that the World Health Organization came out this year and linked preserved meats to colon cancer. So we're aware of that. So let's look at ways we can prevent cancer together by coming to a common consensus when it comes to philosophy of health, fitness, and lifestyle in general. So let's look at this. And it's up to you to make your own choices. I'm just going to provide evidence. Disease affects me very closely. I've suffered my own. I believe I've now found the cure for my disease, and if we have to go through that together, then we'll go through that together. So I went to this. Okay. Alkaline diet. Here, you can take a pause, look, read. I'll link for you the study below. I just want to show you guys. I'm not going to nitpick at conclusions in the study. You should know this. Real environmental and public health. Your pH level. If you don't know, by the way, the lower your pH, the more acidic you are. That's why your stomach, it's like sulfuric acid, right? Really destroys like everything. That's its job. When it says protein, you gotta remember protein is just amino acids. Meats and dairy are not just protein. There's also protein in all of your foods you ingest. Okay? So be very clear with that. You can go through your own study, but I want to link. These are your foods. Now, we gotta be aware of the language here, guys. Words like potential. Okay, words like not a direct measure. You got it for the verbiage, guys, when it comes to reading these studies. This is why you shouldn't believe anybody. You should do your own homework. You have to look at the language, may not, of the entire study, okay? But these are the foods you have to look at, the acid loads, as in their potential. So they're the foods. I was surprised. Look at this. I was surprised. Look at this. But there's no gram or a quantitative number. Keep that in mind, guys. There's no gram or quantitative number. Right? Anyways, guys, here, look. This I found very interesting. As we age, there's a loss of muscle mass, which may predispose to falls and fractures. A 3-year study looking at diet rich in potassium, such as fruits and vegetables, as well as reduced acid load, resulted in preservations of muscle mass in older men and women. So what we're looking at is, in accordance with this study, is that your muscular tissues, which you often believe the protein to be sustained, it's not true. When you eat healthy, you can sustain your body. You just have to eat quality. And then everything I say on diet leads me to 0.8 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight. Maybe you go 1 gram of protein per gram of body weight. Perhaps that's the healthiest way to look at it. Oh, and exhaustive exercise here. This is not really important, but if you exercise, less acidosis in the blood. Okay, that's the key to that. Guys, so what this led me to, you gotta go through your own homework though, check out your own studies, pH levels of food, go to your own homework on it, because do not believe everything I say. Click on Google Scholar. Go to your own homework, just do it for half an hour, take 3 days a week, see what you come up with. But let me hear, the follow-up with this stuff, just check this out. Let me to this guy. I don't know why that happened, but let me to this guy. Dr. Sebi. A gentleman at work introduced me to him. He's a vegan and sent me his knowledge. And I came across this article that he linked to me here. Now, right, that doesn't catch your attention. Wait, hold on. Check this story out. Back in the 1980s, Dr. Sebi ran for a variety of newspapers, like New York Post, stating AIDS has been cured by the Ushuaia Research Institute, and we specialize in cures for sickle cell, lupus, blindness, herpes, cancer, and others. They had caught the eye of the Food and Drug Administration, the FDA, and the agency subsequently sued Dr. Sebi. They sued him. Sued him. The judge presiding over the case requested Dr. Sebi provide witness for one of each diseases he claimed to have cured. 70. 70 witnesses for his argument, showing without a doubt he did heal all diseases. Just declared not guilty. Guys, consider that. Consider this. Consider this. Consider this. Guys, this can go far. Right? Electric foods. Something I go to is this electric universe, but also it takes you to electric weather studies, which have predicted quakes. My electric universe, though, but like, check this out. Look at the title. 7 big quakes predicted in a row. In a row. How do you not follow that? How does mainstream media not cover that? But look, electric universe theory, guys. There's a lot to this, which I was very surprised about because I've been looking at it like a skeptic. But a lot of the science and a lot of the things that they say seem to hold true. Electric foods, alkaline diet, what is really healthy? The ones that I've lost, the ones that I'm losing, please. Stop it. Just stop it. Just stop doing stupid shit. Take care of yourselves.
I love you. Rest in peace, Wayne Bridges. You still living through me.
Look, I lost my father to the bottle. I'd hug him every day like I might not see him tomorrow. Got enough sorrow for a lifetime. Cause when he was living, I'm thinking, how do I get him to listen when he was seldom in his right mind? My early years, I was too young to understand, but I remember the smell of beer and seeing all them empty cans. Waking up, crying in the night, hearing arguments. Hands off my mama, somehow knew he was the cause of it. Got a little older and he got a little worse. Drinking must be his remedy, he got a little curse. Well, tell me what's the cure for a man who misses pops? The beat goes on, but the drinking's gotta
stop.
Come on.
If I had to know, I wouldn't see it tomorrow. I would have grabbed a hold of your heart and put your love in a bottle. But now you got me drunk off that pain, gone off that sorrow. Wishing every day you were here with me. But now that you're gone, I lost my heart to the bottle, to the bottle. Whoa.
Yeah, I lost.
lost my father to the bottle. Functioning alcoholics, what they called it, far as I know. Became a teenager and started to understand. But even through the drinks, he still taught me to be a man. So before the hospital, what the paramedics rushed him. Any and everybody who met him instantly loved him. Ironic how Conjure would've made him even sicker. Cause who gon' tell him he can't drink none of his son's liquor? And tell me, without my father, how am I supposed to manage? He had the biggest heart, but also had that liver damage. So tell me, what's the cure for a man who misses pops? The beat goes on, but the drinking's got to stop.
If I had to know, I wouldn't see it tomorrow. I would have grabbed a hold of your heart and put your love in a bottle. Hey, but now you got me drunk off that pain. Gone out the sorrow, wishing every day you were here with me. But now that you're gone, not a day goes by that I don't miss you and don't wish you were here with me. No matter what you did, I forgive you.
Yeah, I lost my father to the bottle. Tell your parents you love them, you might not see them tomorrow. I swallow my pride, try to put my problems aside, but I feel so hollow inside. Gotta keep my eyes on the prize, cause I'm steady wishing you were here to see the goals that I plan to reach. You left the day after I put you in my Grammy speech. It's almost like you waited just to see me win. Well, pops, I can't wait until the day we meet
if
again.
If I had to know, I wouldn't see it tomorrow. I would have grabbed a hold of your heart and put your love in a bottle. Love in a bottle. But now you got me drunk off that pain. Gone out the sorrow. Wishing every day you were here with me. But now that you're gone,
best wishes and good health, guys. Take care.